Shisky, today's video we're going to prepare you for a trip to Poland, and we're going to teach you some of the Polish words that you may need to know, as well as the Polish alphabet, and we will be tracing them with our flashlight to help you relax as you get ready for your trip. So I've got our handy dictionary right here that will help us out. Some words that we need to know, some places that you may end up visiting, and we're going to teach you the sound of the letters that you'll need to know so that you can practice what it sounds like, and so that you can practice pronouncing the letters and seeing what they look like. So we're going to get started. Most of the letters of the Polish alphabet are the same as they are in English, and they're to say they are, I would say som, S, and then A, and it has a little tail. The letter B is the same as what it is in English, B, very simple. The letter C is like a TS. D is the same, D. The letter E is pronounced E, like the English word let or get, E. E also has the letter in Polish, so it has a little tail, and it's also very nasal. It sounds a lot like the N. G is G. H is H, just like in English. I looks the same as in English, but it's pronounced E. Also has what's called L. L, it's the L, and it has a diagonal line through it. It makes the W sound in English. W. M is the same. N is the same. O is always pronounced just like P, P, A. Q is not used very commonly in Polish, so you will see that a lot, unless it's a word derived from another language like English, so it would just be the same K. R is like the single R in Spanish. It has a little trill to it. T is the same, but it's very light. Instead of a hard t in English, it's just put your tongue to the back of your two front teeth. U is U, so ooh. Also not commonly found in Polish. It's just going to be a word derived from another language, so you could use the same V. However, W does make the V sound in English. So like very, except it's W. X is the same as some of the other letters. It's not very commonly seen, so it only can is not very common, it's just a light as well. And then Z is also Z. Also not very common. A few letter combinations that you'll want to know the pronunciation to. The CH, if you see ACH together, it's a harder H sound like almost in the back of your throat. Z, zh, and very low, zh. SZ is like the English SH, but it's very low. Same thing with CZ. If you see a C and an I together, it makes a higher. Also see a C with a little diagonal line above it, which also makes the ch sound. Same with S. You'll also see a Z that has either a circle over the top, which will make the sound zh, very low again, just like RZ. And you will see the Z with a diagonal accent over the top, which makes the sound zh a little bit higher. You almost have to smile. Zh. Okay, so those are the more common Polish alphabet letters that you see in everyday Polish words and conversations. So a few words that may be helpful. Dzień dobry. It is spelled DZIEN with an accent over the top. If the N has an accent over the top, it almost sounds like there's a Y that's very slightly pronounced. Dzień. It almost makes the E turn into an A sound, but it's very subtle. Dzień. The DZI. That makes the J sound much like the English J. Dobre, spelled DOBRY, why making the E sound. Dzień dobry. Dzień dobry means good day or hello. A little bit less formal is cześć. CZES with the accent and C with the accent. Cześć. Cześć. Common way to say goodbye is to say until we see you again, which would be the words do. Essentially mean until, do, and then widzenia, widzenia, W-I-D-Z-E-N-I-A. D Z E N I E. Dovidzenia, which essentially means goodbye. We'll continue to teach you more of the common phrases that you'll need. We'll just stick with a long goodbye for now. But I'm going to teach you some of the names of the different locations that you may be visiting on your trip as you go to Poland. Poland in Polish, the simplest form would be Polska. Polska. Trust you have your copy by now, yes? Okay, great. We're going to teach you some more common phrases. I'm not going to spell them all out to you. I will continue to use the flashlight to help you relax. I have found that relaxing and keeping calm is a good way to learn this foreign language. Polish is a very simple language to read once you know the sound of the letters, because it is some common expressions and explain how to pronounce them. And then we will do a few regions of Poland that you're going to be visiting on our trip, okay? I will continue to use the flashlight to help you relax. You can follow it with your eyes as I move it around from side to side and up and down or in a circle. Or if it helps you, as I move the flashlight around, and that will help you relax and concentrate as well, okay? Alright, let's get started. The first phrase, which means come here, starts with a CH, which remember makes the hard sound. And that phrase is chodź tu, come here. The next word, if you need to tell someone to back off, cofnij się. Cofnij się. If you need to ask someone what they want. Czego chcesz? That's a tough one. Czego chcesz? If you need to tell someone to be careful. Ostrożnie. Someone to listen, you can say the word słuchaj. If you need to say it more powerfully, słuchaj mnie. Słuchaj mnie. To say look out or watch out, uważaj. Say, call the police. Wezwij policję. Wezwij policję. Slow down. Wolniej proszę. Wolniej proszę. Get back or come here or return is wracaj. Wracaj. If you want to say, stay here. Zostań tutaj. Zostań tutaj. Those are some common phrases that will help you out on your trip, and we'll keep practicing. Województwo Dolnośląskie. Województwo Dolnośląskie. We're also going to be visiting a city in the east of Poland called Lublin. That area is called Województwo Lubelskie. Województwo Śląskie. Województwo Śląskie. Last place we're going to be visiting on our trip is the capital of Poland, which is somewhat to the northeast of Poland, and that is Warsaw. Województwo Mazowieckie. Województwo Mazowieckie. I see you are starting to fall asleep, so we will be finished for the night and we will continue to learn more Polish phrases. Practice our